In this video lecture, we will discuss how to solve first order system of homogeneous linear differential equation using eigenvalues, eigenvector methods, where the eigenvalues are m1 and m2, both are real and equal. So this case we can classify into two cases. The case one, there are two linearly independent eigenvectors b1 and b2. That means in that case we have to choose b1 and b2 such that this b1 and b2 are linearly independent. That means we have to find the longest scan determinants for b1 and b2, and we have to make sure this determinant is not zero. So when we find the eigenvalues, then we find the eigenvector for the respective eigenvalues. To put this eigenvalue here, we get this type of system. In that case, we have to choose two linearly independent eigenvectors. So let us consider an example. Here I choose an example, x prime equal to 2x, y prime equal to 2y. Here x and y both are dependent variable, t is independent variable. So we write this system in matrix form, x prime equal to the coefficient matrix A and X. So here A equals to 2 0 0 2, I equal to 1 0 0 1, because A is 2 by 2 matrix, so our I also 2 by 2 matrix. Then we can find MI equal to M0 0 M. So we have to find the characteristic polynomials. So here we subtract MI from A, then we get 2 minus M 0 0 2 minus M. Then we get the characteristic polynomials. After that we consider the characteristic polynomial equal to 0, that is called characteristic equation. So we get the characteristic equation 2 minus M, 2 minus M equal to 0. When we solve this equation, we get M equal to 2. That means our M1 equal to 2, M2 is also 2. So we have to find the eigenvectors for M equal to 2. So to find the eigenvectors B1, we consider this equation A minus lambda I times B1 equal to 0. Here we already know what is our A minus lambda I, and B1 is an arbitrary vector. We choose here B1 equal to AV. So here our lambda equal to 2, then we put the lambda equal to 2 in A minus lambda I, that means a characteristic equation, and we put B1 equal to AB, then we get 2 minus 2, 0, 0, 2 minus 2. Here M equals to 2, that means lambda equal to 2. Then when we simplify, we get 0, 0, 0, 0. That means we get 0 A, 0 B. That means we get 0 equals to 0, that means there is no equation, but 2 unknown. That means we have to consider both A and B are free variables. So when in 2 by 2 matrix both A and B are free variable, then we have to choose two linearly independent eigenvectors for the solutions of this system. So we consider here B1 equal to 0 1, B2 equal to 1 0. Because B1 and B2 both are arbitrary vectors, so we have to make sure that the longest scan determinant for B1 and B2 is not equal to 0. Here we find the longest scan determinants, so we can see that B1 0 1, B2 1 0. When we find the determinant is equal to minus 1, that means the determinant value is not 0. So we can make sure that B1 and B2 are linearly independent. Then our general solution is x equals to c1 b1 e power mt. Here our b1 equal to 0 1, m equal to 2, plus c2 b2 e power mt. Here our b1 equal to 1 0. So this is our obtained answer. Now we will discuss case 2 b. Where only one free variable, that means we get one eigenvector b1. then we have to use this eigenvector b1 to get the b2. In that case, we have to write the solution as x equals to c1 b1 e power m1 t plus c2 t b1 e power m1 t plus c2 b e power m1 t. So let us consider an example. Here I consider this example x prime t equal to minus x plus 3y. Y prime t equals to minus 3x plus 5y. Here x and y are both dependent variable, t is independent variables. So we can write this system in matrix form, x prime equals to ax, here a equals to minus 1, 3, minus 3, 5. So in this case, we choose our identity matrix 2 by 2 because our a is also 2 by 2. So the identity matrix is 1, 0, 0, 1. Then our characteristic polynomial, we need a minus lambda I. Here a minus lambda I means we consider a minus mi. So in that case, we subtract when we multiply I by m, then subtract from a. So in that case, we get a minus mi equals to minus 1 minus m, 3 minus 3, 5 minus m. So this is our characteristic polynomial. When we consider this determinant value equals to 0, is called the characteristic equation. So here we get the characteristic equation m square minus 4m plus 4 equal to 0. So when we solve this equation, we get both m1 and m2 equals to 2. That means our eigenvalues are equal and real. So now we have to find out the eigenvectors. So first we find the eigenvector b1 for m equal to 2. In that case, we put m equal to 2 in this matrix, minus 1, minus m, 3, minus 3, 5, minus m. Here, AB is our b1 matrix. That means in this case, we use this equation, a minus mi b1. Is equals to 0, 0. Here our b1 vector is arbitrary vector. We choose a and b. We have to find out this a and b. So when we put the value m equals to 2, we get minus 3, 3, minus 3, 3, b is equal to 0, 0. When we write this one in the row echelon form, that means our target to make it 0. So we subtract R1 from R2, then we get this is 0, this is 0, this is 0. That means when we write this one in equation form, we get 3A equals to 3B. That means here we get minus 3A plus 3B equal to 0. That one gives 3a equal to 3b, that means a equal to b. So now we have two unknown, a and b, only one equation. That means we have one free variable, we choose the free variable is b. So you know that we can choose b equal to any real number. Here I consider b equal to c, c is any real number. Then we get a equal to c. That means our vector now b1 equal to c, c. When we take common C, then we get 1, 1. So C is any real number. For simplicity, we choose here C equal to 1, then we get B1 equal to 1, 1. So this is our B1. Now we have to find the B2. To find B2, we use this equation here, A minus MI, already known. B2 is arbitrary vector. We choose B2 equal to AB. And B1 is our obtained B1 in our obtained solution. So that means we already get B1 equal to 1, 1. Now we put m equal to 2 in this equation. We put B2 equal to AB and B1 equal to 1, 1. Then we get this matrix system. So minus 1, minus 2, here m equal to 2. 3 minus 3, 5 minus 2. That means after simplification, we get minus 3, 3, minus 3, 3. This one, B is arbitrary vector. So we try to make it row echelon form. So we subtract R1, we subtract here R1 from R2, then we get 0, 0. Here this is R1. Here this is just R1. Subtract R1 from R2, then we get minus 3, 3, 1. This all 0. That means when we write this one in equation form, we get minus 3a plus 3b equals to 1. That means we get a equal to b minus 1 by 3. That means here we have two unknown but one equation only, so we can choose one free variable. In this case we choose b is free variable, and we consider b equal to c any real number, then we get a equal to c minus 1 by 3. Now we have to choose c so that we get a equal to a simple real number. So in this case we choose c equal to 4 by 3 so that we get a equal to 1. Then we get b2 equal to 1, 4 by 3, because we can choose any real number for c. So for our convenience, we choose here c equals to 4 by 3. Then we get a equal to 1 and b equal to 4 by 3. So now we write here the general solution x c1 b1. We already know our b1 equal to 1, 1 and m1 equal to 2, so e power 2t. And c2 is arbitrary constant t b1. B1 means 1, 1, e power 2t, because m1 equal to 2. Plus c2, also arbitrary constant, here our b2, 1, 4 by 3, e power 2t. So this is our solution for this system.